Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to vector a cartoon panda. So starting off here, I'm in Pixel Persona in Affinity Designer, and I'm working out various sketches for the cartoon panda I'm working on here. Client approached me. He wanted three different versions of a cartoon panda, each with boba tea, because it's for a boba tea business. So I'm just working out the various sketches right now, seeing what'll work and what won't work, what I like and don't like. And at each stage, I just keep refining the sketch further and further by starting a new layer and lowering the opacity of the layer below it. That way I can draw over it. This stage is important to just try out any and all ideas that you may have. See, I make the cup a little bit larger here. I'm messing around with the size of his body. So this is definitely the stage to play and experiment, and where you will take the time to find out, you know, exactly where you want to go with the final illustration, final cartoon. At the same time here, as I'm working out the sketches, I'm also thinking ahead and how I will be actually vectoring the cartoon when I get there. So here, I'm doing a more refined final sketch for the panda. Again, really considering how I'm going to vector these shapes once I get to that part of the process. Think about how shapes are overlapping each other, how you're going to close those shapes in to make them work a little bit better. And then here you can see the three different sketches that I had worked up, and then also a visor option. So we've got one with the panda sitting there, him in the cup, and then also one with him chasing the boba tea. So here I've started a new document, and I'm pulling over the first panda with him just sitting there drinking the boba tea. In this group here, I've got the visors separate from the panda sketch, so I'll go ahead and turn those off here in a second and start the actual vector process for the panda. Now, there's a couple of different ways you could go about approaching the vector part of this process here. You could go and start with the pen tool and create the shape manually, you know, point by point, until you create the whole shape. Or you can use, as I end up here, using the Shape Builder tool to build out the shapes. I've been using it more and more for various things such as this, just kind of to be able to find the shapes. So what I'll do here is I've got the Ellipse tool, and then I'm just resizing it right now. In a little bit, you can click on Convert to Curves up at the top menu bar right there. And this will give you more ways to manipulate the ellipse. You'll have your node handles, and this is a way I just try to find the more specific shape that I've drawn. I've kept this part of the video normal speed, that way you can kind of see the process and how I'm tweaking each of the shapes. So again, starting with an ellipse, if I can manipulate the ellipse without converting it to curves, I'll do so. So there, that was a pretty good match. I'm selecting the Shape Builder tool, and I will now just add these shapes together. So once I've got that, I'll switch the fill to stroke, and I'll find a nice stroke weight for the outline of the character. Again here, I'm going to use the Shape Builder tool to create the shape here, and that time I use the subtract. And again, I leave myself some room to play around in vector to try different things while I'm still working in just vector and whatnot. So, you know, you may try something and realize that it doesn't quite look the way you want it to. So, no problem. Just go ahead and get rid of it and try something new. Just creating the subtle shapes of his mouth. Here I'm using just stroke lines, and these here, I'm going to try to hide the mouth behind those other lines. Again, when creating these shapes, I always generally like to create the ellipse, and then I'll convert that ellipse to curves, which allows you to then use your node tool, A, to manipulate each of the nodes and the handles to get a more specific shape. Again, as I'm building out these vector shapes, I'm layering them one on top of the other. So once I fill them in color, it'll overlay on top of the other shape, hiding the other shape behind it. And I'm working on one side, since the panda is symmetrical, I'm working on one side at a time, and then I can just duplicate it over to the other side as I did there. But then you'll see I'll back it up because I want to go in and start adding some more of the details to these specific parts. I want to add the little fingers of the paws. I'm eventually going to come in here and add color to each of these sections as well. So it's a good idea if you are going to flip artwork from one side to the other and whatnot to finalize whatever side you're working on before flipping it. You'll see I do, I flip it a few times here and always end up going back to finish the shapes before pulling them back over and whatnot. So sometimes I'll duplicate them and switch them to the other side just to make sure everything's lining up and looking right. Sometimes I forget and have to go back and go, oh yeah, you know, maybe it's time to add these details before I pull everything back over to the other side. I like to clip shapes inside of the main shapes as much as possible. So I'm always keeping in mind ways of doing that. Here I was having an issue figuring out how I wanted to hide the mouth behind like his puffy cheeks. So I was trying to cut that shape and it wasn't really working out and giving me the results that I was looking for. So at some point here I just kind of, yeah, I filled the top cheek shapes to match the color of his face. And then I just think I kind of hid the mouth behind those shapes. So it ended up working out okay. Art is always about trying to find what's going to work for the desired effect you're going for. So sometimes you may have an idea about how you might want something to work or look, but then when you're actually in the process of creating it, you might find out that it didn't exactly work the way you wanted to, or you might have to try something different. So always be open to those opportunities as they come up. Don't ever let yourself get too secured in your own idea and your own sketches. You know, be able to let the sketch is the base idea, but allow yourself to be able to grow and build off of that sketch and let it evolve naturally, even when you're finalizing the artwork in the vector stage like this. Again, just continuing to work out all the various aspects and shapes that I want to go ahead and use. Here I'm heading in a highlight. Keeping the shapes fairly simple, nice and cartoony. Keeping the colors bright and saturated. I wanted to stand out. And then here's where I realized, okay, let me come in and start adding some highlights and shadows just to round the cartoon out a little bit more. Depending on the project, sometimes if you're creating a cartoon a vector for certain logos or certain projects, you may want a more simple, more flat styled cartoon. Other times you want something that may have a little more dimension, and then other times you want things that have quite a bit of dimension and form. So it really all depends on your personal style and also what project you're working on, what that specific project is going to require or need. When I'm working in the highlights and the shadows, for something like this, I'm keeping the light source very simple. The light's coming from the top, so all the tops of the shapes are going to be hit with the lighter tones, and then obviously all the shapes, the bottom of the shapes are going to be in shadow. If the light's coming from the top, the head would be hit in light, and then we'll cast that shadow down onto the body. Here I'm coming back to the pixel persona where I had sketched out some bamboo as a edit element to the design. Actually, I drew this straw and I had thought about it a little bit later. It hit me all of a sudden. I was like, hey, you know what might be kind of cool would be to have the straw he's drinking the boba tea out of actually be a bamboo straw. So that's what I'm doing here. So I'm working out the vector shapes here on my sketch file in Pixel Personer, and then I've just copied it over to the document I'm currently working in to then come in and fill in the colors and make it work with the illustration a little bit better. Once I had it in there, I realized, you know, what might make it look a little bit better and a little bit cooler would be some leaves. So just resizing them here, I'm going to put them in place. Then I'm always trying to make sure, too, I'm paying attention to the different stroke weights and whatnot and making sure everything kind of matches and blends together. Here I'm adding the highlights and shadows to the actual little bobas in the boba tea. I'm not sure exactly what those little things are called. And then I went ahead and I deleted the others and reduplicated that one to go ahead and keep the highlights and the shadow shapes. Just moving around a little bit to get a pleasing composition form. And here I thought it'd be kind of cool to add some sort of cast shadow from the bamboo straw itself. Now I'm also going in and adding some more form to the bamboo by adding shadows, and I'll come back and add some highlight shapes to it as well. You're working on various aspects of the illustration. You do want everything to have similar level of detail. Faces and whatnot, you could put a little bit more time and attention into since that's the primary place that people will look. But as far as everything else in the illustration, you want it to be fairly balanced in its detail. You control the level of detail to direct the viewer's eye. So areas with more detail versus areas of less detail to help balance out where the viewer is looking. I thought a second smaller leaf would just balance it out and make it feel a little bit better. All right, and that basically wraps up our cartoon panda. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found the video helpful. Please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on new tutorials just like this. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.